Researchers in India have been doing a trial of a new type of birth control for men. Now, this birth control is reversible, so it's different from a vasectomy. And what basically happens is guys will get a very questionable injection, and the injection destroys their sperm. And believe it or not, that injection is reversible. So let me tell you more about it. It's known as reversible inhibition of sperm under guidance. That's what it's referred
to. Yeah, good. You want the guidance there.
And the way that the process works is a doctor applies some local anesthetic, thank God, makes a small pinhole in the base of the scrotum, reaches in with a pair of very thin forceps, and pulls out the small white vas deferens tube. Then the doctor injects the polymer gel called vasal gel, pushes the vas deferens back inside, repeats the process for other vas deferens, puts a band-aid over the small hole, and the man is on his way. Now, within about a few hours of this injection, a man can have unprotected sex and not have to worry about getting the woman pregnant. And if he decides, you know what, I actually do want to have kids. And by the way, this is effective for up to 10 years. So, and in the clinical trials, I should note they're just trials, this form of birth control was effective 100% of the time. That doesn't mean that it has no side effects. It doesn't mean that it will be effective 100% of the time as soon as it's out on the market, but it seems like it's promising. Now, in terms of how you can make it reversible, all the guy has to do is go in and get a different type of injection, and the injection is made of water and baking soda.
Bacon, interesting.
That would be ridiculous. Water
and
baking.
Everything has bacon these days.
Right. Anyway. And it would basically reverse the damage that was done to the sperm. Or it's not necessarily damage to the sperm. The gel does something, so when the sperm passes through the tubes, they get torn apart.
And the gel just lasts for 10 years.
It lasts for 10 years. It's kind of incredible.
So, look, I'm going to question certain aspects of this, but to head off some of the, like, oh, they're against science, I understand that it says they've been studying this for 25 years and it's safe. I'm shocked that we haven't heard more about it if they've been doing it for 25 years or that they don't have a product yet.
I've heard a little bit about it. Unfortunately, the US media has been very slow in covering this story, but I have read a few articles about it prior to it becoming.
Of pills. But not injections.
I've heard about the injection. Okay. And I think that it's definitely a good alternative for people who don't want to have kids, but don't want to go on birth control, like females don't want to go on hormones or whatever it is to prevent pregnancy, because a lot of women have a very negative reaction to birth control pills. This is a great alternative if they do find that it is 100% safe and, you know, we can put it on the US market.
It's interesting, but I didn't know about the procedure until you read it. Like, I imagined it's bad enough that they like inject something into your penis, but the fact that they have to like pull out the tubes and everything, that seems weird. I also question why water and baking soda just clears it right up, a couple months, no problem.
Yeah, it is interesting.
That seems questionable. And just the very idea of, like, I understand, again, this is like totally safe, I get that, but the idea that we're gonna inject something into your penis that just dissolves stuff, just sperm, maybe other stuff, you never know. I don't want any stuff that dissolves things in my penis. Seems a little bit weird.
Look, there are
But anyway, look, I'm just joking around.
I know.
Something like this needs to happen. It's not a good thing that we only put birth control on women, you know, aside from condoms, I suppose, and expect that they'll be the ones to take care of that. And I think that this will be good, that men should also have to think about it in a new way. I think the question is, like, are women gonna trust guys who say, oh yeah, don't worry, I got male birth control 8 years ago.